guys, it's your boy Chris, and welcome back to my favorite 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last and all stuff I picked up wins up in the league over Leicester and in the FA Cup over Wigan. In this episode, we're going to have a league game against Southampton, and I will also be playing in the first leg of my Champions League knockout stage, the first knockout stage matchup against Athletic Bilbao. But as I said, I do have Southampton first, because I almost have to wrap up in the league. Well, giving only a few more games. I think it's like 4 or 5 I have to win, and then I'll be champion. I did mention this in the last.
Two changes for Southampton today.
Aya Yoshida starts. Despite the table, but that's okay. I can forget it later. But yeah, 22 points clear of Arsenal, who are currently second. Now Chelsea could go second today if they win their match. And oh, that is a fantastic start. Nice. He's Neymar. Very nice.
Well, he's beaten the keeper there with power, with accuracy.
I saw the shot was on and I'm like, yeah, go for that. Like I was saying, Chelsea could go top. I mean, they can't go top. They can go second if they beat.
A great to watch this Liverpool team. Look at the amount of goals they've scored. Top scorers. Well, they play such an open.
I forget who they're playing.
At times, but
I am brilliant. I completely forgot who Chelsea are playing. They are 2 points behind Arsenal. I should memorize some of this stuff. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they're 2 points behind Arsenal, so that would mean they would go a point ahead of them if they do win. And we'll see how Chelsea are getting on at halftime. I do have it set to keep me updated, but depending on what happens in my match, they'll just completely ignore the Chelsea game. At times.
Well, he's pressed him there to running the ball out of play. Well, they're wasting no time with the throw here.
Ooh, I was gonna go for the shot again. But, Mayo. He was alert.
Ryan Bertrand. And he's lost the ball.
Fail. Back at Southampton. And of course, came through their academy.
And in he goes with the tackle. Ricardo Rodriguez. Get his cross in now.
Mad skill by Ricardo Rodriguez. Now for Southampton man, Nathaniel Klein. Had a go. Why not? And forced the save out of Fraser Foster, so why not? Why the hell not?
Brilliant football from this team. Here's a chance to whip it in.
Oh wow, that's not a real card for Nathaniel Klein. I thought that'd be a foul. It wasn't even a foul. Never mind the yellow card. Didn't even give it as a foul. Apparently, Klein didn't do anything wrong. And it was a goal kick as well.
Oriol Romeo.
Klein didn't take very well, but it was still a goal kick.
Goes across. He's made the save.
Royce, go.
I don't know whether the visitors will be being G'd up by.
Oh wow! Brilliant.
Comfortable win. They had the superiority on their own ground, but you know, football is strange. The game should be played.
And again, Freaking hell.
Well, that's right. And they should be full of confidence, shouldn't they? Because I think they are actually a better team than their opponents today. So
go on, Grant. Yes. What's going to come to Neymar? They're giving me the free kick instead. Is that Neymar we're done to that? To be fair. See, I need a left footer out here, so bail. Go against his former club. Go for glory, Gareth! And he's fucking useless.
At Neymar's goal.
28 goals and 28 appearances.
Liverpool's match at this point, but there's a lot more of it still to go.
It's not a bad, that's not a bad average, to be fair.
Time left all of the second half, of course.
What is his first full season at Liverpool? I didn't say he was well, I think, did I? It's Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace is who Chelsea are playing, and they are going to beat them because they're 2-0 up. Unless Crystal Palace pull off the comeback of dreams.
Game to win, really. Now they've got the lead at half time.
Yeah, it's looking good for Chelsea that they will be in second place. So Arsenal will have to fuck up against whoever they're playing. I don't know who they are playing because they're not playing at the same time as me, and I could not be bothered to look.
And that goalkeeper can just saunter out and pick that up. And coming up for you on EA Sports, that Premier League fixture for Southampton. They'll be hosting Spurs. Yeah, a lot of people.
Yeah, what was I talking about? Oh, yeah. I was saying that. I don't know if I mentioned this at the start of the season. Start of the season? Correct me if I'm wrong if I didn't. But I think I said that Neymar would have been one of my picks for top goal scorer this season, along with Correa. So, no. I think I said that, did I? I don't know. And Laporte, they're getting his name on the score sheet.
Well, it was
Or is it for Rain who doesn't have a goal? That might be Laporte's first goal of the season. I'm trying to think, is it him who has already gotten the goal this season, or is it Varane? Foster made the worst attempt at a save ever. Like, the header didn't look that difficult, and he kind of jumped out of the way. That's definitely Laporte's first league goal. I'm pretty sure that's Laporte's first goal of the whole season in game 27 of the Premier League. And Varane has something like three.
Good challenge between the two of them there.
Oh, the time to get Americ. Well done. Welcome to the party.
Poor touch and the possession's gone away.
To the man. Ah! She got a very good work to cut out the pass there. Royce.
Play here.
Ricardo Rodriguez! Oh!
Had to really reach out for that. He has been pressed there too. Running the
sure, that's a free kick. He was tripping up to help.
Towards Neymar. Varane penalised here.
Are you gonna be kidding me?
Ryan Bertrand.
Now the shot. No. Ooh. Oh, it's light. is as far as down the pitches it'll go.
Liverpool's next game.
Yeah, they're playing Bilbao in the next match.
Where
the
they fall out. But it's coming straight back. Oh! No? Really? That is some hope for a challenge. And I'll take that easy goal kick. Well done, Merrick. Yo, defensive and offensive in this match. Merrick is trying to get himself that Man of the Match award.
Liverpool's throw in. Ricardo Rodriguez.
Oh, Correa. Brilliant. Has to be a goal. Yes, indeed it is. And that is the 3 points wrapped up. Yoshida is pissed.
He's certainly hitting with accuracy.
No one to blame but yourself. You were right there. You were in the best position to stop, to make a challenge. You know, you could just dive in front of the ball. Or keep your arms out so the ball doesn't hit your hand. And you're golden. If you block the ball, then golden. If you don't, you can at least say you did try to stop it instead of standing there like an idiot and then complaining when the ball goes into the net when you could easily, he did something except stand there like, again I said a complete goddamn idiot.
Come out of that tussle well with possession.
Go Neymar's gonna get there. Yes it is. Turn. Simmons! And ball.
Peter out that attack.
That was actually a cheat as well. That time he got in the way. Hey, when did that error? So you wanted. Did you just want to. Frickin'. Oops.
That's a foul by Gareth Bale.
Look. Oh, that's not even a yellow. Brilliant.
You've got to time it.
I guess the referee doesn't give a shit. He's like, ah, go away. Leave me alone. There's the full time whistle. Oh, 3-0 is the final score. Just get the final result of the Chelsea match. This should be in second place. Yes, indeed they are. They won 3-0 as well. They added a third goal just for good measure. Or, as I had predicted, Chelsea were not really in any danger of throwing that away. It didn't. I mean, I don't. I'm trying to think where Crystal Palace are in the career mode. In terms of reposition. I don't know, maybe they're mid-table? Excuse me. Let's see, Crystal Palace. Oh, they're above the relegation zone. And Arsenal did play? And I was right about them being 2 points ahead, Chelsea. See? So hang on a second. Talk about a reversal of real life. Look at that. Villa are fourth and Leicester are bottom. In real life, Leicester are top and Villa are bottom. Oh, this game. So, apparently, in FIFA, Villa are good, even though in real life they're terrible. And in FIFA, Leicester are terrible, even when in real life they could be Premier League champions. Okay, FIFA. Mm-hmm. I mean, in saying that Chelsea and Liverpool have not had their best seasons in real life either. And the fact that Arsenal are even still being mentioned in the title challenge is a crime, because they're out of it. I don't care what Arsenal say, they're out of it. They're not winning it. No way. It's between Spurs and Leicester in their life. And really, it isn't exactly going to be close this in between me and Arsenal in the game either. One slip up, and they will be in deep, deep shit in terms of I know my first game of next episode is actually Captain One Cup Final against Man City. I'm trying to think, is the other game in LA Bilbao's second leg, or is it a league game? It's a league game. Ironically, it's Villa! Welcome back. Oh, irony. Yeah, that's hurtful. Interesting to see who Arsenal is playing in their next game. I just wonder, are they playing when I'm not? Because they might be. Because in real life, there were fixtures on when Liverpool and Man City played in the capital, in the real life capital. Well, let's see, one of the penalties. Arsenal are playing on the 24th, they're playing Leicester. It's like this game is listening to me or something. Is that? Yeah, that's the day before City, so so I'll have a game in hand after that, which is brilliant. So I'll win a trophy, and Arsenal might drop some goddamn points. Profit all wrong. What am I doing? Episode isn't over yet. Chat is banned, so I'll use this game. I don't know how Chan got banned. But he got sent off in the group stage as well. I remember him getting sent off in the group stage. Then again, that's been a while. Have to keep Adaris quiet. He is a very good striker in this game. Like, it's not just me who thinks this. I've heard a lot of other FIFA YouTubers singing praises the guy as well for Ultimate Team. I'll tell you this, he's good in career mode too. I've used him in one of my off YouTube career modes, and he just bangs in the goals like nobody's business.
That's a good challenge.
You think Neymar is back paying him in the league? Adaris could give him easily give him a run for his money.
The keeper, he is just flat-footed, and he can only admire that, the way he's hit it first time.
We can see a slightly different viewpoint on it.
That is a fantastic start. Well done. Thank you, Ian Nacho. Now we can build on this, and hopefully we can waltz our way to an in.
Terrific tackle. And here comes the counter attack.
We win.
And shoots!
And I can send the second leg. And that guy is super lucky. That would have been a penalty if he had connected with that slide tackle.
He's clawing at thin air.
Let's see the replay now.
Yeah, I guess it depends on whether the referee would have sent him off or not. Because it could have easily ended up being a red as well, because that would have been from behind challenge. In the box. Would the game have defined Donza as being in a goal-scoring opportunity position?
Adarid, he's cut out that pass, it wasn't an accident, he read the mind of the opponent.
Great work. There it is, Nagoski.
He's made sure he's protected it.
Yep.
Hey, Marcos. Benya. Williams. Valenciaga. A real winter spectacle here. And the tackle's living up to the spectacular. Benya.
Wilson. Three. And that's up.
Hey, Marcos. Benya. Medell.
2-0. It's good, but it's not good enough.
Well,
I was thinking that might have gone out of play, but clearly because the game didn't stop it. And I'm glad it didn't, because it's now 3-0. Thank you, Diva. Yo, I might get to send that second leg after all.
Exactly where we
want. Oh, I thought Athletic Bilbao were better than this.
And here is another angle on that goal. Liverpool really on top form in their first half.
Graham, one of their best players is my player now. And that's America Laporte.
Shilio.
Shilio. Briggy. Ah! I thought I'd get the pass through. Who should have gone over the top, perhaps? Lesson learned.
Gary Medda. Benya. It's a neat pass. And now the shot! Fine save he's made there, and he's not
that could have easily been given as a penalty. Yeah, I got super lucky there. The referee. He was lenient. Thank you, ref. Once he wouldn't have given the man the red card either. But
they've managed to read that back in.
He didn't give him a penalty against me, so I will let that slide.
Draw
9! And Iturbe puts away the rebound. It's 4-0 before half time! Yo! Oh.
To make your mouth water. Great goal! Well, the goalkeeper did his very best, but I think he might have regrets that he didn't get hold of
it. That is over!
First half in this game. Have a look at that scoreline. Crowd maybe expect
4-0. Highly unlikely. And it's 4 away goals as well.
Well, that is going to be the goalkeeper's quite straightforwardly, quite simple. Well, can you believe what we've seen in the first half? Half time.
Like, it's highly unlikely LA Bilbao are gonna come back from this. That's not happening.
Cup match for a place in the quarterfinal.
Any don't care what crazy fantasy you live in. I'm the most hard-headed football fan. And whether you were a leg football fan or you're just a hair of Liverpool, there's no way you can say he with any amount of honesty that you really do not let football will get back to this match in the second leg. Even if I stopped playing and let them get a consolation goal, they would still need to score for 4 goals in the return leg. That was a fantastic save by Dragowski. I didn't even stop playing, but they almost scored anyway. Great catch from the goalkeeper. Now the break is on. Go, Dunza, go. Only Shianacho. Whip it in. For Origi! Why didn't you header it? Like, I know we're 4-0 up. We're cruising. We're cooking on gas. But, you know, header it. Why didn't he header it? I am massively confused as why he didn't header it. It's like the most logical choice. He went, I'm not okay with going the logical choice. I prefer to go with the less obvious choice, actually. See, well, I'm not so. He didn't even go for the header. Or maybe it's the cross was too low?
Bilbao, I'm going to make a change now.
Corner.
Substitute coming on.
Bilbao making a substitution.
It's a headed effort at goal.
Orban. Well,
I thought he might have tucked it away, but well, maybe next time.
Well, the tackle there has led to a throw. Gary Medel. Wasteful pass, unforced error, really. Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
Listen.
Ivo Carigi.
Let's keep that in. And go with Torre.
We could be in. Off the ball.
Oh, wow. Seriously? I can't believe I messed that up. Come on, I have to redeem this.
Here's the shot.
Oof. The rest is here. We'll have to get in the way. That would have been... Well, at least the shot on target. There's 5-0. That's Sewell, I think.
Just looking at that deflection. Of course, defenders do get attracted to the ball.
Yep. Well done, Nicholas.
The goalkeeper behind him is actually getting that point across now.
One team really on their game today. The other very
German. Seals the deal.
5-0 still, and the referee checking his watch. What does this mean for the
Payanacho?
Ball go up against Manchester City.
Why the hell not at this point? Let's come to Wilson. It's 6. It is 6. Bloody hell, it is 6.
And that's blown.
I mean, when you find a gem, you just know you find a gem.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
Samuel Wilson.
Such a one-sided affair, but look at the scoreline. Balenciaga.
Seriously, there is no move point to the second leg.
Mounier.
4-0. Ooh, was ludicrous. 6 is mission frickin' impossible. And I'm not talking the movie starring Tom Cruise. It's seven. Like, can someone give a like about a white flag that they can just wave? Save me a lot of time.
Could say really game over. Hey Marcos.
There's the full time whistle. Oh, the referee has put Athletic Bilbao out of their misery. I beat them 7-0. The second leg can rescind. I could put out a team of absolute 40-something kids I pulled off the street, and I still will have no problem progressing into the next stage of the Champions League. So yeah, all in all, very productive episode. Would absolutely delight with that. And yeah. Next episode, what are we going for? For the first silverware of season 3. He has a... revisit the actual Capital One Cup final winner that happened in real life, only in the game. Liverpool versus Manchester City. He gonna make sure there's a different outcome this time. And there will also be a game against Aston Villa in the Premier League. Because I go in search of securing that as well. But until next time, so thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you didn't subscribe for content very, very soon. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very, very...